everyone, and a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. So guys, in our previous session, we have learned about how we can obtain HTML using beautiful soup. In our today's session, we are going to talk about what are tags in HTML. So guys, to understand tags, there is a very simple method that if you remember learning HTML in your childhood, there must be something called as tags, where which has open tags, closed tags. And if you have not heard about it, let me just explain it to you with the help of an example here. So here, if I go back to my browser again, I have this webscrapper.io, that test website here. And if I talk about the tags, here you can see that there are something called as there is head, and then again there is head. So what is this? This is a tag which is an open and closed tag. Again, we have a body. The body is also a open and closed tag. As you can see, as soon as I click on this arrow, here it is closed. Inside the body, the whole thing, the whole code of the page is written inside the body, and its properties are basically written in the head and also the title. So this is our head, this is our body, and here we can here you can see this div. If I close this, there is also a closed tag here. That means this div is also a tag over here. But is only the div a tag over here? Suppose inside this we have different things. For example, let me just close it. Let me just close this. And if I open this one, there's nothing inside this one. Let me just open this one. So if I open this, we have again div. Inside this, again, we have another div. Inside this, we have another div. Inside this, we have another div. We have another thing called as UL. UL over here is, understand them like a list here. Basically, they are list only. UL over here is unordered list. There are two types of list, ordered and unordered. But again, we will not go in the depth. Again, just consider this as a tags over here. And then we have list items inside it. We have products over here. That's a paragraph tag here. Okay. So here again, we have a A tag. A is the anchor tag. That means inside this, we have given a link here. And if you click on it, something will open. Okay. So these are some examples of tags that we have, different kinds of tags over here. And if you want to access these tags, if you want to see all these tags in our Python, all you need to do is go into your program. And here, let's again, I'll write import requests. And I'll also write from BS4. So I will be writing this again and again so that you'll remember the syntax here. And write beautiful soup. We'll pass the URL. Inside the URL, I guess I have this URL. No, we do not. I do not have this URL. So I'll just open this Chrome and copy the link. Come back to my program, pass this URL over here. I'll write r is equals to requests.get. And I'll pass this URL inside. We will not print the response here because we already know that the response says okay here, and that means we can get the HTML. And here we will be writing soup is equals to beautiful soup. Inside this, we'll be passing r.text, comma, the extension LXML. Passing LXML is very important because we will be handling this data. So whatever data we are getting from r.text, we will be handling this in the format of HTML. We will be getting this data in the format of a string here. So instead of printing, if I print soup as of now and run it, so you can see we will get almost everything which is there in here. But if I only want to get the tags from here, I only want to get the div tag. Now for that, I'll write div dot div and let's run it. And you will see that I'll get the, previously it wasn't starting from div, now it is only starting from div. Now you will see that you will also see that there is this a tag and then span tag, and then we have a button here. Okay. So what are all these things is that inside the div tag, there are different tags, and because we have called the div tag, it has also called everything inside it. So if I just explain you about the div tag is basically nothing, but when you create a website, the website needs to be divided into different parts. So they divide it into different divs, and then inside this, they add the data, whether it's a button, whether it's a drop down, whether it's a list, whether it's an image. Okay. So here, if I talk about this also, it is one complete div in which we have different divs, with in which one div contains the image, one div contains this link, one div contains the price, one div contains the description, one div contains the reviews, one div contains the stars and the reviews. So this is how it works basically. So inside this divs also, we have different tags. That's why when I have tried obtaining the div over here, in that case, what I have received is everything that is inside the div. So these are the tags basically. So as of now, for understanding web scraping, for learning web scraping, only this much information is enough, that what are tags. So I hope after this video you have understood that what are these tags. If I explain you in a better or simpler method, everything that you are seeing in this dark blue color, or if this let me just try changing the theme here. So here there is an option to change the theme as well. And if I get this theme in white color, because generally it comes in white in color. So let me just check theme, system preference. Let me just go with the light one. Okay. And if I just click on the cross. So here. So now you can see the actual colors of everything, and everything in purple color is a tag here. So header is a tag, div is a tag. Everything that is coming in the purple color, that is the tag. So I hope now understanding what is a tag is better. It's much more easier for you. So guys, in our next session, we are going to talk about what are attributes in HTML. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.